Do you want to know about the only fat guy in North Korea?
Yeah.
We're going to tell you about him here on 105.9 The Mountain, Nashville's Classic Rock. It's the Rizzo and Jeff Show. And Jeff, you know what? I never thought about it, but you're right. Everybody in North Korea is so skinny.
Right.
They're hungry.
They are. They are looking for a bite to eat. Yeah.
They need a few bites to eat.
Yeah, well.
They need a burger. They need a bird dog.
Well, the one guy is sitting there eating all of the bird dogs and kicking back, lighting up his Newports and, you know.
hanging with Denny Rodman.
Yeah, hanging with Rodman.
Then you got everyone else tilling the field.
Right.
It's really not a fun existence.
No, if you've watched videos, it doesn't look like a good time. And all those people there are like zombies, man.
They are. They're just like, thank you, General Secretary.
Right.
And if you're like, but see,
Supreme leader. But here's the thing.
So like they award radio show hosts with beautiful homes and flats. So it's like, maybe what we should do is take the show on the road.
Yeah.
Head to North Korea, and we'd get a lakefront 8-bedroom flat in Pyongyang.
Is it on the water there?
It's on the water there in Pyongyang.
All right.
Right where Generalissimo Kim Il-sung lived.
Oh, there's probably only one nice house sitting out there, you know? Everybody else, when you just look at the buildings, it looks like they're all different colors, and it looks like skyscrapers are just empty, and, you know.
I believe half the city was built and painted, but there's nothing in there.
Right, because he wants to make it look like it's a prosperous city when it's not. So they built it up just to have a bunch of buildings that nobody's in.
And you're saying, how do you know all this?
Yeah.
Well, that's because of this new song that everybody in the West is jamming to, and that brings us to opening audio.
It's time for opening audio here on the Rizzo and Jeff Show, a fun, funny way to start your day on 105.9 The Mountain.
Now, there's a North Korean pop tune that, you know, has gone viral, and people are actually doing dances to it on TikTok. Now, I don't know the last time something from North Korea went viral.
No.
You know what? It might be that lady, the news lady, who always seems pissed off, right? Like this lady.
합중국 대통령은 이에 이해를 표시하면서 조미 사이에 선의의 대화가 진행되는 동안
She's always angry. Right. It's like,
no, I can understand what she's saying. I get the frustration in her voice there.
I mean, first off, she got a flat.
Right.
She wears this beautiful pink sash. She's like adored. She's like the Morley Safer of North Korea.
But isn't she like the only one who goes on TV and talks about stuff? It's like her and that's it, isn't it?
She's the only one allowed on television.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. And they have one lady that does radio.
Right.
Like, that's it.
That's it.
So, it is what it is. But anyway, this song here talks about how, I believe the translation, again, you know, there's no literal translation because there are different words and all that. But it's something like, if you love the leader, he will repay you, like, with houses and rice and grains and kisses.
Oh, okay. So, he's going to give you some Uncle Ben's and a kissy poo? Uncle Ben's and a kissy poo from the Supreme Leader.
You
huh?
get Uncle Ben's and a kissy poo. So good morning on a Monday. Here's your Uncle Ben and kissy poo, North Korea pop it. So if you love the leader too, okay? Mm-hmm. All right. We'll give you Uncle Ben's and a kissy poo. So,
and they have amazing audio quality there as well, as you can tell, there in North Korea.
Well, yeah. People are you know, if you're familiar with TikTok, you take a video, you could do something called Stitch It. We have one at 105.9 The Mountain. You should check it out. We do a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff there. You can see the studio and whatnot. But people are stitching this video, and they're dancing to it. But basically, you know, you get rice and kisses and houses and things if you love Generalissimo Kim Jong-un.
Think about how off of a place you're in when the excitement is the fact that if you are kind to the leader, that you get Uncle Ben's and and a kissy poo. And that's what you live for every day of your life.
What? What's wrong with Uncle Ben's and a kiss?
Doesn't sound too bad, actually.
The Rizzo and Jeff Show has been here for a while.
There's something not right about these guys.
The Rizzo and Jeff Show. We'll be right back on 105.9 The Mountain.
Sometimes people feel certain ways about certain things. Sometimes people, you know, try to find the lighter side of life. You know, I think that, you know, we as a show try to look at the smilier side.
Yeah, yeah, that's the smilier side. Yes, yeah. that's the goal every day. Generally, things happen once in a while, and sometimes you have to pivot. But yeah, our show is generally that.
Well, there was a school that was shut down and put into lockdown because of a squatch. And you say, what do you mean by squatch? Really, truthfully, a daddy squatch. Apparently, it was a dad of one of the students, they later found out, who just dressed as a squatch and started banging on windows. He thought he was a real silly guy.
Did he? Or did dad wake up and have himself a little Banker's Club vodka to start the day, huh?
Banker's Club? I'll tell you what, that would be, you know what, that would put you in a daddy squatch costume, right? Banker's Club's tough.
Banker's Club's a rough go.
Yeah.
That would definitely be the one. That's what, you get it by the big jug, you know?
Yeah, for like $7.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is a news team that is divided. And I want you to hear, there's the two guys here that are trying to add a little bit of levity. And then you have that news kid. You know that news reporter that just will never break character no matter what?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, there's always, you know who's like that blitzer? You
know, Wolfie
Blitz.
Wolfie Blitz.
Wolfie Blitz doesn't give you anything. He doesn't deviate. Yeah, he. Somebody like him, as an example.
I'd love to go on his show and like just say random stuff. Like, what if I hit your speed bag?
And see,
you know what I mean?
And see how you're what if I paddle your bag? And here's the thing. You're right. I don't think that he'd break. I don't think he would.
What the hell's going on?
I don't know.
All right, anyway.
I don't know.
We're talking about paddling boys back.
All right.
Anyway, so this daddy squatch, our heads and news team divided.
Time now for your weekly Sasquatch update.
In all seriousness, though, guys, Firelands Elementary School went into a lockdown on Wednesday. And according to school officials, an unannounced visitor came to the campus dressed in costume.
Uh-oh.
The video was posted to Facebook, showing someone who appears to be wearing a Bigfoot costume running past classroom windows. A letter was sent to parents saying in part, quote, "While some people may make light of the situation, the fact remains that we cannot waver from the side of safety. The individual induced panic on our campus and this type of behavior will not be tolerated."
Yeah.
And we can assure you no one was hurt. The Lorain County Sheriff's Office confirmed to 3 News that the suspect, actually a parent, who did this. It was
prank. It's that time you think about the senior prank season. It's May. Everybody's ready to get out of school. They do these things. The seniors do these things. I do not recommend that because we did that in high school and we got in some trouble for it. So
wait a minute, though. It wasn't a senior prank. It was a dad.
It was a drunk dad who decided at some point he had made up in his mind. This is not a spur of the moment thing.
No.
To purchase a Sasquatch outfit, and then as you're going to taunt a school with children, you decided to do that. So it was not something that he just, he just picked up on his way to go grab a cup of Joe. Nobody deviates from their morning routine
to squatch
to go buy a Sasquatch outfit and run around the school and pound on windows. What sense does that make?
It makes none. I think the moral of the story here, and we got sidetracked, is I think you need to be more like Wolf Blitzer.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. Hey, Wolf.
Whether it's the who, what, or why. The Rizzo and Jeff Show won't be able to answer that. Just try. The Rizzo and Jeff Show. We'll be right back on 105.9 The Mountain.
A drunk Dickie Flair, there's nothing better. It's 105.9 The Mountain. Classic rock. You got the Rizzo and Jeff Show. Jeff sometimes acts like an idiot behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Listen, Ric Flair got in a little bit of a heated debate while he was trying to take a pee. And I think he...
Well,
tried to get a little tough.
Well, here's what happened with the Nature Boy. And, you know, everybody knows Woo, and he's become a cultural...
Oh, we have some audio.
He's become a cultural icon. Yeah. I think probably more in his life now than he probably was back in the old wrestling days, you know.
Do you think so?
Oh, yeah. Back then, he was in, you know, some of the lower tier stuff. You know, if the guys are old enough listening to remember NWA and things of that nature. But it wasn't as big as Hulk Hogan at the time, right? So... but he was very well known, and I've heard people say, I've never seen Ric Flair drink a glass of water in his life. He enjoys the cocktails a little bit, to the point now where as he's getting older, he doesn't care. And the situation that happened down there in Florida was that he really had to be cut off at the bar, and he wasn't having it.
He was not only not having it, he then went into full 1980s Ric Flair Nature Boy mode.
Bad for you. Why would it be bad? That bad for you. Why would it be bad? Well, watch social media tomorrow.
I don't watch social media.
Well, you better. You don't have to do this to me. I didn't do one thing wrong. I walked into a bathroom.
And you cussed on my kitchen manager.
I never say a cuss word. You know, is that his word against yours? I didn't say one cuss word. You're disrespecting me.
How am I disrespecting?
Telling me to leave.
I'm not telling you anything. We're just telling you that you're cut off.
Oh, I'm cut off because I'm cut? Really?
Yes, sir.
Come on, sit here and talk to me like a man.
I'm not going to do that.
Uh-oh.
Dress myself in cashmere. Woo, 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 woo. You keep your mouth shut. I'm gonna go in and slap your face. Who are you? Diver, tell me. I am Ric Flair, the president of the United States. Woo, 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 woo.
I think he got carried away at the end there.
Yeah. Well,
You know, well, I feel like you don't tell people you're the president of the United States.
Yeah, well, you don't cut off Ric Flair. We got Johnny.
What's up, John?
Yeah, man, I'm listening to the man, baby. Woo!
Yeah, woo! All right, so what do you think? I mean, he was told he's no more drinking. He got a little PO'd and turned into Ric Flair of the 80s.
Well, hey, man, look. Ric Flair is Ric Flair, 80s or no 80s. I've been to some WWE matches, and when you're sitting in the stands before the matches start, somebody up in the balcony will go, woo, and the whole entire place will start going, woo. So he's still a major icon, and he is the guy that actually brought wrestling back and to where it is today.
I agree with that. Okay. Everyone says it's Hulk Hogan. Oh, I completely agree with you that it's absolutely Ric Flair. He was the first big superstar.
Watch the documentary 30 for 30. Hulk Hogan will tell you that Ric Flair is the man. Any wrestler will tell you Flair is the man. And you don't cut Ric Flair off. Okay, if you do, you're asking for the figure four. And, you know, it's not good.
He's got a figure four. The poor college kid is just running the local bar.
You know it.
Oh, yeah, man. I'd be like right there with him, man. I'd be doing a suplex, headlock, you know, elbow drop, come off top rope.
So you'd you would suplex local collegiate workers for Ric Flair if they cut him off at the local tappy?
Oh, yeah, man. It'd probably put him... I'd probably put him in the sleeper hole, man.
Oh, my God.
Wow. We got a text that came in and said, Ric Flair's blood type is Beef Eater Gin.
Johnny. With his grandchildren in the car.
He's going to tag up with the Nature Boy.
And he's going to suplex collegiate workers?
Young college boys just trying to make a buck. Woo!
More Rizzo and Jeff coming up after a quick break on Asheville's classic rock station, 105.9 The Mountain.
It's 105.9 The Mountain, Asheville's classic rock station, and you are just bumming people out, Jacob.
I hate to tell you, but they're about to be more bummed out as I fail the next three.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know about that, Jeff.
Well, look, if you're just tuning in and you're going, what are they talking about? Last week, Jacob let us know that he knew a lot about music from the 1800s, okay?
So, yes.
So what we did last week is we pulled up some of the, I guess, pop stars of the 1800s. All of them, which he nailed, by the way.
Yes.
Maybe missed one. I don't know. I don't even think he did. So we figured this week what we're going to do is we're going to test, you know, his, you know, knowledge of celebrity artists. So these are famous people that not only famous for acting and things of that nature, but they also are musically inclined as well. And some you might get listening out there and, you know, some you may not. Jacob, on the other hand, seems to be getting none except for one, which, you know, maybe the multiple choice thing, isn't it?
The multiple choice thing was your idea.
Do you want to ditch the multiple choice now?
I want to ditch the multiple choice.
Okay. All right, this is going to get ugly.
Is that fair?
Yes.
All right. So, for that being said, we have three more for you, okay? And I thought that, you know, you might get Eddie Murphy. I thought you might get, you know, I thought you might get a few of these guys. But anyway... So here's your fourth one, all right? If there's anyone that you're going to get, I figured it'd be this one. You watch him every Sunday.
Does he?
He, well-known football star.
We'll give you a hint.
Okay, all right. I'll tell you what.
He's on a panel of folks on, you know, when the NFL comes on. He's one of them. He's a talking head on there.
Is it Howie? Let's see. Is it Jay Glazer? Is it Howie Mandel? Or is it...
Howie Mandel,
French Stewart, or I don't know.
Howie Mandel. It's not Howie Mandel.
He's not a football player. I would love to see it.
Deal
but he's
or
not.
No deal. That's Howie Mandel.
I was trying to throw him a little bit.
Okay. Well,
not
going to
get me there.
You're not going to get him on Mandel. He knows Mandel.
Okay. All right. So, Fran Tarkenton or...
he suck.
You did okay. See, that's why I said ditch a multiple choice.
You couldn't give him like Phil Sims, you know, who's not with it anymore. You know, James Brown,
Fran Tarkenton, or
Fran Tarkenton.
Who are these people?
I you know, guys.
It's Terry Bradshaw.
Okay?
I got it.
Okay, you got it.
There you go,
Fran Tarkenton.
I was trying. Okay, fine.
Bart Starr.
Broadway Joe.
Yeah, Joe Namath.
Joe. All right, here we go. She's taking my heart. She doesn't know what she's done. Feel her breath in my face. Her body close to me. Now, very, very famous, versatile. Somebody that you wouldn't think could sing like this. Just a fool to believe I have anything she needs. She's like the wind. Pop culture icon.
No longer with us.
Pop culture icon. Ghost.
Actor.
God. Oh, Chris Farley and him did a dance.
Yeah, no.
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 Patrick Swayze.
All right.
I know the name, couldn't put a face on it.
Yeah. Okay.
You don't know any Patrick's ghost, nothing?
No.
Okay.
I'll have to go home and complain to my parents.
Yeah.
Tell them they should have taught me better about Eddie Murphy.
No, well, you're going to go in and have those conversations. They're going to complain to you and say, guess what? These college loans, no parent plus. They're on you, pal.
Yeah,
The Rizzo and Jeff Show. It's like watching a car drive down the wrong side of the road. You can't look away. The Rizzo and Jeff Show. We'll be right back on 105.9 The Mountain.
This is the time of the week that we get the company of our wonderful intern, and it's so nice of him to join us. And last week, Jeff, he showed us that he knows pop culture.
Well, he knows pop culture from, you know, the 1850s on. So he's very in tune with
that
era of music. So this this we feel, if he seems to be in tune there, and he's a young man of a certain age, yeah. And you know, intelligence, and he's lived a little bit of life in a short amount of time. I think he's going to know some of this stuff.
We think we have a good selection. So without any further ado, intern Jacob, we're doing celebrities who have also had storied music careers, right?
Okay.
So it's kind of like a twofer here. Are you ready for it? All right.
Maybe. We'll see.
All right.
Take a listen.
Here's our first one. Take a listen. Tell us who this is. Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider. No, you don't want nada. None of this. Gunning this, brother running this. Buffalo soldier. Look, you can tell us to stop anytime you know.
That won't be necessary.
Okay. Oh, you know it?
Maybe.
Okay. Sure. All right. What do you got?
You said it was multiple choice, right?
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, you threw out the multiple choice.
You got to give it to me now.
All right. Is it Arsenio Hall, Eddie Murphy? Okay. Is it Will Smith or DJ Jazzy Jeff?
Well, I know Will Smith isn't really known for his musical career, so I'm not going to go with that.
Okay.
Let's just go with Eddie Murphy. Why not?
Eddie Murphy. Yeah. That is Will Smith in Wild Wild West. Right.
Really?
Yes. Yeah, okay. Yeah. That's Will Smith.
Will Smith in Wild Wild West.
One of Rizzo's, by the way.
One of my favorite songs. One of my favorite songs. Yeah. I love a good Will Smith tune. He can entertain, but without being naughty.
Right.
All right.
Has that changed since the incident?
Yeah, he's been quiet.
He's learned his lesson. All right, so okay. Listen. Okay, let's see. Let's move on to celebrity singer number two. But you're not doing good right now, Jacob.
What era are we in right now?
We're in everything past 1850.
That's where you went wrong.
We're going like, you know, 1970s to like 1990s.
He did get Stamos, so you got to give him that.
We multiple choice it, and he picked Stamos because it's the only name he's ever heard before.
Well, guess what? If he was on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, he would have got it right. Okay, him and Regis.
That's
and
true.
You know who Regis Philbin is, right?
I do know who Regis Philbin is.
Okay, all right.
You're a Regis guy.
All right.
I wouldn't say I'm a Regis guy, but I know who he is.
Are you anti-Regis?
Not really. I'm just indifferent.
You're indifferent on Regis.
You know what he would say? You know, he'd be like, Jacob, you're bonkos.
You're bonkos, Jacob. All right.
Nothing here.
Crickets.
Still at a loss.
All right, we got cicadas over here. So we got it's either Prince, Harry Connick Jr., Eddie Murphy, or Purple Zap.
I'm gonna go with Prince.
Mm-hmm. That's Eddie Murphy's Party All
Dang
the Time.
It.
1984 hit.
That was
a number
84.
One single.
Yeah, Party All the Time by Eddie Murphy. You know Eddie Murphy.
It could have been a Purple Zap song. I would have also accepted that answer.
Yeah. So Eddie Murphy there. All right, Jacob.
It's okay. Hey. Listen. We're not here to judge. You know, we got three more. You can come back, right?
I've been told Jacob's good at around two. Okay, that's what I hear around campus. So
is
I'll
that
tell
what you
what,
hear around campus? Jacob He's can, a good rebounder.
Jacob can go for round two. So I think coming up next, we'll give him three more shots, three more whacks at this. What do you say?
I say three more whacks. It is.
All right.
Whether you think your prime was the 70s, 80s, or the 90s, at least you had one. The Rizzo and Jeff Show is still waiting for theirs, and the time's flying by. The Rizzo and Jeff Show on 105.9 The Mountain.
It is 105.9 The Mountain, Nashville's classic rock station, and we have a special guest on line one. Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hi. Is your intern still there?
Yes, he is.
I have a bone to pick with you, sir. Did you say you were 22 last week? Or how old are you? Just 21. Okay, well, I'm going to be 23 on Sunday, and I know who Patrick Swayze is. Okay.
Well, happy birthday.
Yeah.
Yeah. And how old are you going to be? I'm sorry.
23. 23? 23, she said. Yeah, so is it just ignorance that you think he doesn't know Swayze? Do you think maybe he's lived a sheltered life? What do you think it may be?
I think he's just uncultured.
So we need to culture him.
We need to culture.
That's what we're trying to do here. We're giving him Swayze. We're giving him Eddie Murphy.
I mean, did you know some of the other ones, too? Did you know, like, Will Smith? Did you know, Eddie Murphy? Oh, see? Now, let me ask you. Maybe you could give him some culture. Do you have a boyfriend? You want to maybe, take him out on a date? He's a good-looking young man.
Oh, sorry, sweetheart. I'm married.
That's it. All right.
So how do we get him some culture down here in Nashville before he goes back to Orlando? The land of no return.
Honestly, I don't think he has any hope.
Down he goes.
Down, Jacob, go.
How dare you?
Wow. I got to tell you, first off, at 23, you're very smart and cultured. Yeah. And for him not to have hope, I appreciate you, calling and voicing your concerns. I think they're valid.
Yes, they are. Okay, I have two. You don't know any Patrick Swayze movies. You don't know Dirty Dancing. You don't know Two Wong Fu thanks to Julie Newmar.
No, I've never seen any of them. I'm quite happy sticking under my 1850s rock.
He said he's happy with 1850s. How about this? You never seen Chris Farley and him dance?
Nope.
Yes, I have.
Well, and he hasn't.
You know what? I'm glad you're just as befuddled as we are. You know what? Thank you. And be careful on the road out there, okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm at work right now.
Oh, good. All right. Well, you know what? We'll try to culture Jacob up just for you.
Okay, well, I hope so.
All right.
Have a great day. Thank you so much for your call. See that, Jacob? You're upsetting the beautiful young women.
I'm sorry.
Around your age group, 23.
And you know what? You could have been married. Look, she's married. Now she can't call. Maybe she would have offered up one of her good-looking friends had you known about Swayze.
I have no hope for marriage.
No. Not
I'm a lost
rate.
Soul.
You know what? That's all of us here.
Wow. Okay. We're heading places today.
Yes, we are.
The Rizzo and Jeff Show. Hey, here's to hoping we made the right decision. Find us on all socials, 105.9 The Mountain, and by searching Rizzo and Jeff Show on all podcast platforms.
Is there anything worse than continual nonstop diarrhea? It's 105.9 The Mountain, Nashville's Clay Scrock. Hear me out. There's a reason we're talking about this. This poor woman, she goes to Dr. Jared Janis. And she is to the point now where she's had so much that she's threatening to basically off him, take him out. And I got to be honest with you, part of me doesn't blame her, Jeff. I don't know how you feel, but if somebody caused you to just have constant the runs, I mean.
There might be honestly nothing worse than that. I mean, I would, if somebody said, you'd be one-armed or one-legged or have constant diarrhea, I would probably give up a limb to not have to deal with that on a regular basis.
Yeah, you know what? Thinking about it, there is probably... Okay, wait a minute. Would you rather have halitosis or diarrhea all the time?
Halitosis. I don't care.
You'd rather have halitosis?
Yeah, good. People stay away from me with halitosis. I become the guy that's known to have bad breath continually, and then people will stay away from me. I knew a guy with halitosis. I stayed away from him.
You knew a halitosis guy?
I did. I worked with a halitosis guy, which is constant bad breath, and I would totally stay away from him, so people would stay away from me. It'd be perfect.
Okay, well, this woman, she recorded secretly her interaction with the doctor, and it has gone viral because she's in tears. She's like, I just can't stop. The runs just please, and this is what happened.
Jared, do you think that there's a moment that goes by where I don't think about your face and hurting you? Jared is the one. You, Jared, are the one. This was the course of my life. The course of my treatment for my ulcerative colitis. I was about to try Stelara and Xeljanz together, and he just destroys. shatters the life that I had.
Shatters the life.
Do you see?
Shatters the colon.
Do you see the pain? Do you see? You can't go anywhere or do anything.
You're right. You're right.
You can't get on an airplane. How do you get on an airplane?
With diarrhea? Well,
if you're in the middle of a flight, even a quick one from here to, you know, I don't know, Orlando. Maybe you want to go see Mickey Mouse.
Yeah, you can't see Mickey.
And then if you make it, okay, down to Orlando, how are you going to go to Disney World? What can you do?
Well,
you walk a little bit, the bowels get moving, and then boom. So no Space Mountain for you. Then you're on Space Mountain, you're on the ride.
And then it's all over.
It's over.
I mean, all because of some Zeljans. Can you take a hardener? What's the stool hardeners called?
Yeah, I don't know them by name. Sorry, but I think that once it happens, there's really not much you could do.
I made a mistake one time of taking too many fiber gummies, and I had to go out at 3 o'clock in the morning. Imodium. Why couldn't she just Imodium?
But don't you think that hasn't been thought about and tried? And sometimes when it's just to the point of, you know, Mount Vesuvius, what can you really do at that point?
So what do you do here? Well, what's the end game for this woman? Is she just doomed? Does she just end it? Does she go Kevorkian? What would you do?
Your whole life is
the runs.
What do you think she's going to do?
What?
Stick a cork in it? She's screwed.
Whether it's the who, what, or why. The Rizzo and Jeff Show won't be able to answer that. Just try. More of the Rizzo and Jeff Show on 105.9 The Mountain.
Not sure if you're familiar with the artist Jelly Roll.
Of course you are.
But if you are, you know that Jelly Roll is a larger man. A Jelly Roll to me smells.
And we got into this conversation earlier because when I saw the picture of Jelly Roll and sweating, and I thought that he was in a rainstorm. But then we started venturing in on, celebrities who we think when you meet them, you know, they smell. And it started kind of yesterday with Steven Seagal.
Well, it because I just would like, because this is a different audience. We talked about him at a different time. You need to know the truth. Steven Seagal stinks.
Yeah.
All right. He smells like a turd wrapped in burnt hair. Okay. He smells like burning rubber and cat matter. Okay. The guy just stinks.
Yeah.
He doesn't shower. He uses his own homemade deodorant.
Okay. And you know, look, I gave you somebody that I thought, if I was to meet them, in my mind, they would smell. What if I said the name to you and just you've taken a look at him? Adam Sandler.
Oh, total stinker.
Right.
Total stinker. You know what it is? It's because he releases the quiet farts. He crop dusts.
He's a no-care stinker, right?
I
gave you another one this morning. I threw out a name to you, Mickey Rourke. Now, Rourke.
The wrestler?
Mickey Rourke, who obviously...
The guy from the movie The Wrestler?
The guy who...
He was a hunk in the 80s.
He looks like that Catwoman now, okay?
Got a lot of plastic surgery.
I said that looks like a stinky to me.
Well, you know, it's funny. I have a couple stinkies that come to mind, and actually intern Jacob reminded me of this one. I mean, this was Shaquille O'Neal. And you know what? If you don't mind, we're going to talk to him later, but why Shaq, Jacob?
Shaq's just a big man. I mean, there's only so much you can do with that height and that weight. I mean, I couldn't smell good if I was that big. It's not his fault.
You couldn't shower?
I mean, you can shower, but there's so many crevices and cracks all over. Right. There's canyons, even.
I believe it.
Shaq has canyons.
I'm sure.
You're too tall to get down to get everything, right? It's got to be difficult for him.
And let me just throw one by you, and that's a great suggestion. I can't wait. Jacob is going to be doing some pop culture stuff. Thank you, Jacob. Mike, what do you got here, huh?
I bet John Goodman from Roseanne, the famous actor.
Yes.
He's lost all that weight. He's kind of getting older. He's getting healthy, but I bet he's kind of got that like late 80s uncle from Chicago smell.
Yeah, I think he does smell like a Chicago-style hot dog.
So
You know what?
Flabby, old man,
right.
Post-fat smell is what you're saying.
That's what I'm saying. Old Spice, kind of maybe some English leather thrown in there, maybe some Stetson, if you will.
Yeah, a little, some Gold Bond medicated powder all mixed into one.
Kind of cover it up, yeah.
Hemorrhoid ointment. Bratwurst.
Yes. Beer.
Like Abe Froman, the Sausage King of Chicago.
Right.
Go Bears.
Go Bears. What do you think about Mama June? If you could describe the smell. We're talking about celebrities that you can just look at and know that they smell.
Yeah.
Mama June.
Yeah. Mama June is just just sulfur. Just I'm like, she's just a walking urinal cake. I mean, that's kind of where I'm. The blue one.
The blue urinal cake? She smells like multiple people peed on her.
Yes. Why? Do you disagree?
No. 240-1059.
The Rizzo and Jeff Show. One loves Frasier, and the other's still into wrestling. Who's who? Find out more interesting tidbits about them every morning.
Who do you know that just stinks? You just look at them and you go, they smell like just beef jerky and like toilet.
Yeah, celebrities.
Right, yeah. And we had a couple people call. We have some more people that are waiting on the phone. I think, you know, I believe you said that who smelled like urinal cakes?
That was, what was it? Not Honey Boo Boo. Mama June.
Mama June.
Yeah.
You know, people like that. People you just look at and you know that they stink. You know, Shaq. You know, Shaq. He's just so large. There's so many crevices.
I'm sure he tries. Right. You know, I'm sure he tries. Yeah.
I mean, Roseanne Barr. That's a great. You know what? You know who looks like they stink? And it's just by pure coincidence. Whoopi.
Mm.
Whoopi looks like she puts on a lot of perfume, but that you get a whiff of Whoopi the wrong way. The Whoopi whiff.
What are you? You're downwind on Whoopi?
You're downwind. All right. You're downwind. 828-240-1059. A lot of people want to weigh in on this topic here. We got Raquel on the phone. Raquel, good morning. Who do you think looks like they stink?
Danny DeVito.
You know what? God damn. What do you think about that?
Why does Danny DeVito look like he stinks?
His hair's always greasy. And any movie he's ever been in, he's sweaty.
You know what? It's just, you know what? He's the guy that refuses to wear deodorant. You can smell the BO. He smells like a man who just mowed a lawn all the time.
You know what, though? But he has four children with Rhea Perlman. So you don't think Rhea cleaned him up, made him powder or anything?
No, because I kind of think she probably stinks, too. This is the way he always appears.
You think Danny and Rhea Perlman stink?
So Danny stinks because he sweats all the time, and Rhea stinks because we think she's a bar fly. Okay, we got it. Yeah.
All right, well, I'll tell you what, Raquel, I appreciate your call. Thank you very much. Grandma Emma, who stinks? Who do you think stinks?
I tell you what, the Thousand Pound Sisters.
Oh my God, those two girls from my 600-pound life?
Kentucky. No, yeah, Thousand Pound Kentucky. Sisters, the show.
Oh, on TLC.
Yeah, like, and the one lost weight, but the other one just kept eating.
The one that got weight on the truck scale.
They're both losing weight now, but still, I mean, I'm so addicted to this show, but they're so disgusting in how they talk, and you know, it's just disgusting, but it's addictive.
But so they're just fat and gross.
Yeah.
Well, it's got to be hard, Grandma Emma, to clean in all those places when you're that large.
She's got to sit on a stool.
Well, I've had people in my life who have had gastric bypass surgery, and, you know, you do have to bathe a lot. You do. So if you bathe once a week, that's really going to be disgusting or something, you know?
And that one sister who's, like, twice the size of her other sister, that's a hard wipe. You know what I mean?
Oh, I know. You have to have six people to help. I'm sorry. I mean, you know, and I really do feel for overweight people. I really do. I've been overweight my life. But, you know, it's just really, they're just disgusting. I'm sorry.
I know. All right.
Weight loss program.
Come on, Weaverville. It's time to rock out with the Rizzo and Jeff Show. Nobody? Candler? Black Mountain? Anka? Woodfin?
Bueller?
Anyone? Well, they're new, so here's to rocking out.